Hi, my name is David Doss. I'm a composer and a producer. In this video, I'm going to show you all the basics of using Native Instruments Kontakt within Motu's Digital Performer. We're going to cover adding the tracks, loading the sounds, and get you on your way to making music with Kontakt and DP. Now, this video does assume that you have Kontakt and DP already pre-installed, then we'll take it from there. When I first open up DP, I have my new file template, which I personally customized to open up mostly blank, though yours might show some existing tracks. If it does, you can ignore them for now. I'll go to the Project menu. In order to use a virtual instrument like Kontakt, I need both a MIDI track or tracks, and I need a virtual instrument track. Then I'll assign the MIDI track to the instrument track. DP has a neat shortcut to do all of that at the same time. It's called Add Track Instruments with Options. You might want to make a note of this keystroke. It's Command Option Shift I. I personally use it many times a day. When I choose that menu item, I get a dialog box which asks me how many instrument tracks I want to add, let's choose one for right now, and which instrument it should be, so I'll choose Kontakt. Then it asks me how many MIDI tracks should be added to each instrument. Let's talk about this for a minute. The Kontakt plugin can host anywhere from 1 to 16 instruments at a time. For today's example, let's prepare it for 16 instruments in case we want to use them. This is called multi-timbral usage. That's when we load multiple instruments into one instance of Kontakt. We can always delete the unused MIDI tracks later if we want to clean up. We could also put all these new tracks into a folder if we want, but I won't do that for this demonstration. Once I click OK, DP creates the 16 MIDI tracks, creates the instrument track with Kontakt, and it automatically assigns each MIDI track to 16 sequential MIDI channels. The first track or channel is record enabled by default. So now let me switch into Kontakt and find an instrument to load into the first slot. I'll choose the Alicia Keys piano. Once the piano is loaded, let's look at DP. Because that first track is record enabled, it means that any key I hit on my MIDI keyboard is being routed to that MIDI channel, and therefore to Alicia Keys. So if I play, I should hear the piano. Now let me actually record a little MIDI in there to demonstrate. I'll rename my track by option-clicking it and call it Piano. Now it's time to work on a second instrument. I'll record-enable my second track, which is being sent to MIDI channel 2 in Kontakt, and I'll go find another instrument, let's say a guitar. In Kontakt, you can see that the guitar automatically inherited MIDI channel 2, while the piano is defaulting to MIDI channel 1. So, I should be able to play my guitar right now. If I'd like to record some MIDI into the guitar track, I can do that. One thing I'd like to do is clean up my MIDI's timing, so I'll select everything and go to the region menu and hit quantize, which is Command 0, another very common tool. Let's quantize it to the eighth note, and now it should be absolutely perfect. I'll name my second track, again, by option clicking it, typing guitar. Now let's have a listen to this masterpiece. So that's essentially how Kontakt can be used multi-timbrally in DP. Of course, you can use up to 16 instruments in a single instance of Kontakt, and if you need more than 16, just repeat the process by going back to the Project menu, Add Track, Instruments with Options. Over in DP's mixer, you can now mix between these, turning your piano or guitar up or down. This over here is the instrument track, which carries the master audio output of Kontakt. If you wanted a plugin on the entire instance of Kontakt, like an EQ or a compressor or other effect, you could insert it here. And that's your overview of the basics of using Kontakt in Digital Performer.